Before I get into this video, I just want to say a quick announcement that tomorrow is going to be the first live stream of the community reunion, as somebody pointed out in the comments. Tomorrow at 6 p.m. there's going to be a live stream on my channel. That's 6 p.m. UK time. I'm not sure what that is everywhere else. I'll put a link in the description box below so you can have a look. But onwards with the video. I am a stickler when it comes to using facts over your feelings. I never used to be like that. I'm lying down, so I've got a sore back. I never used to be like that. I used to be quite an intuitive person, so I would use my feelings over facts more often. And that was very evident in things like astral projection, out-of-body experience, when the explanations I was giving was based on the things that I had an inkling for, rather than the facts themselves. But it's difficult to argue against someone who uses facts when all you have to back up your claims is your opinions. And it's one of those things that I hate more than anything in the world, is when somebody will argue against you and you say, well, where's your evidence? And they say, well, I feel that this is the right thing, which is fine. You know, you have to go on instinct at some point. But when you go over and over the same points and you become, you can really see my hairline receding now. When I lie down, there we go. How about if I just do that? Can't bite it, fight it. If I can't bite it, fight it. If you can't beat it, eat it. No, if you can't beat it, join it. I'll give you an example. So the whole Koi Fresco thing last year, or it might have been earlier this year, I used evidence and facts to back up my side of the story. Whereas Koi and other people, I'm not trying to single out Koi here, but other people like Koi who rely entirely on gut feeling and it's my opinion and therefore it can't be wrong kind of mentality, they would argue against me. I've had a few comments on Facebook, on my Facebook page, and sometimes on Twitter. And two things. You get the people who don't think that lucid dream is real because they don't think it's real, where they haven't got any evidence for it. And so they often contact me saying, this is a load of rubbish. Are you just in it for the money? I was like, if I was in it for the money, I'm in the wrong industry. But because they don't think it's right or they don't think it's true, then it automatically just can't be true. And the opposite is said as well. Some people will fight facts with feelings in the sense of, well, I'll get some people who say, I agree with a lot of your stuff, but when it comes to astral projection and out-of-body experience, I don't particularly agree with you. And I'm like, well, that's fine. If you don't agree with me, that's fine. But if you don't agree with me just because you have an experience with something rather than evidence, then I'd be a bit more hesitant about trusting the stuff that you say. Ugh. What I'm trying to get at is the fact that use your brain a bit more. A lot of people are very hesitant towards trusting their brain because something sounds off or wrong. And I don't know when it became the norm in which normalcy was not normal, if you know what I mean. So for example, over the times, I feel like more and more nowadays that I'm in the minority. I feel like I'm in the minority when it comes to astral projection, out-of-body experience. And when I say to other people, look, this is what we have as fact and evidence, here it is, and yet they still fight that fact and evidence with something else. And yet they still fight against the facts and the evidence with something else. I feel like I'm in the minority nowadays. And it's been more and more prevalent as the time goes on. I feel like I'm in the minority when it comes to people using facts. Like before, it used to be the fact that you'd be laughed at if you believed in astral projection, out-of-body experience. It still is the case now. But it's more and more common to find someone who believes in that. And when you say, well, where's your evidence? They say, oh, I don't have any evidence. What are you talking about? How can you trust something so concrete without any evidence? But then you get into the whole debate about faith and stuff. Well, how can religious people have faith when there's no evidence for the faith they have? That's the whole point of faith. And I understand that. But even so. So it's Halloween tomorrow, and that's right. At the start of this, like, I'm doing a video every day type thing, I was like, yeah, I'm going to do it 2 weeks in advance so I can, you know, do stuff. I was so busy, I didn't have time to record a video. So this is my video that I'm making today, is actually on the day that it's supposed to be. Tomorrow is Halloween, and we have a live stream tomorrow at 6 p.m. So be there. Information in the description box below into stuff like that. If you are a YouTube member, I think I've only got 3 members at the moment, if you could really be at the live stream, that would be great, because there's some things that I want to test out that are only available for members. It's like emojis and stuff, like my face and things. It should be quite cool. Yeah, we'll see how that looks actually on camera. We'll see how that looks on the day, but I'm looking forward to it. It's been a long time since I live streamed, and we'll see how much practice I need to get in. But yeah, anyway, I did want to say another announcement to those on Patreon. Please check your Patreon page. I made an update on the Patreon pledges. They are changing soon, so please be aware of that. I know some people have already emailed me. I haven't got around to responding, some of them, just so I keep you posted. Things are changing tomorrow, so be aware of that. And until next time, bye.